Hi guys and welcome. In this video I want to show you how I have modified my portable turntable. I think many of you have seen it when I'm using it in my videos, but I also take it with me when I'm going to a thrift store, for example, and want to quickly sample the music that I've picked out and see if it is any good. I wanted to improve the sound quality, but mainly I wanted to modify it because I got the warning: be careful when you're using a turntable like this that you're ruining your vinyl. And I don't know exactly if that 100% true, but because of the cheap construction of the tone arm and the cartridge they use, you have a big chance that you are wearing out your vinyl. And the main cause, I think, is the tracking error. You get a tracking error because the tone arm length is not exactly as specified. The cartridge is a ceramic one. That's also not maybe ideal, but I guess if you have a good ceramic cartridge, it's not something bad. The bad thing is it wears out very quickly. So when you compare that to a moving magnet, it will wear out 10 times as fast. So if your moving magnet goes something like 500 hours to 1000, the ceramic cartridge will only go 50 to 100. And if you use it for a longer time, that will of course be bad for the vinyl. Another thing is of course the tracking force. When I tried to measure the tracking force of this unit, it was the maximum I could measure was 5, and it goes way over it. So I would not be surprised if it is in the area of 7-8 grams or something. And something that is causing this is that there is also a spring. I don't know if you can see it. And this holds also the cartridge to the record, so it's pushing even harder. So I thought the first thing I want to change is the cartridge. If I can change the cartridge, then I can solve a lot of the problems I'm having. It will improve the sound quality, but will also take care of the wearing. So if you want to do this, I wanted to use the same tone arm. So if I remove the cartridge, then you can now see how it is constructed. So you have the cartridge and the tone arm, and you have now to find the cartridge that fits in here. And to my surprise, that was actually not that difficult. I looked at different cartridges, and the one that I picked finally was the Autotechnica 9191. This is a cheap cartridge, around $20. It has a conical needle stylus. That is something I preferred. In general, a conical cartridge is much more forgiving when it is mislined. For example, the height is not correct. A conical cartridge does not, or a conical tip does not care for this. And now, of course, the tricky part is how to get it in. And if you look closely to the picture, you can actually see there is a black piece on top. And this black piece is used to hold the cartridge, hold it like this, to mount it into the head shell. You can modify this one to make it fit in this one. What I did, a friend of mine has a new 3D printer, and that's perfect. That's a lot of fun. So I made my own new black piece that you could put on top of the cartridge. So this one you can easily remove. It's just one screw and you remove it. Then I printed this one, which has the exact dimensions of the inside of the head shell. You have to remove all these black pieces you see inside, and then this piece fits inside. And once you do that, you get this result. And as you can see, it fits very, very nicely. It's almost, almost original. But once you do this, there are, of course, you're introducing some new problems. That's always the case when you solve one thing, you create a new problem. One of the things is, of course, you need to reduce the tracking force. So if you want to reduce the tracking force, you have to put on more weight at this side. Now you don't have that much room because the head cover still has to go on. You can do it in many ways, of course. You can put something on. As we had the 3D printer, I printed this cap, which mounted exactly over this one. And as you can see, this gave the possibility to add some weight to this. I used the nut, put that inside. And then I had almost a perfect weight. I cut off a piece of this bolt. And this piece I could put in here. And I could turn it a little bit. So I had a movable weight, so I could adjust the tracking force exactly. And if you look into the specifications of this cartridge, it runs standard on 2 grams. In general, my experience has now been to run it at 2.5, and that's mainly to do when you put the portable turntable onto a table, it's usually never flat, so it can be a little bit on the left or on the right side, tipping over, and that will put some force, like an anti-bias, anti-skating force onto the needle. And when you put it on 2.5, this influence is less, and I got no mistracking. Well, once you have the tone arm and the weight mounted on the back and the cartridge in front, then you have to tackle the next problem, and that is the sound level. The sound level of a ceramic cartridge is about 10 to 50 times higher as a moving magnet cartridge. So like with a normal stereo, you have to add a preamp. You can use standard preamps, they're quite cheap. You can get them off eBay. I went for a specifically designed one by Bihari. He makes or has designed preamps specific for the Numark, and well, not so specific for the Numark, but the size fits inside. So I wanted to show you this. I already removed the screws. I will also put on the head. Of course, funny, this is the bottom side, and it has the warning sticker. Do not open, hazard risk of electric shock. Of course, you're also ruining warranty most probably. This unit is 15 years old. I don't really mind. But if you're doing it, be careful. Disclaimer is of course in place. Now let's look at the inside. When you look at the inside, you see not so much. This is the motor, this is the tone control, this is the speaker. The speaker I changed, by the way. This is the standard speaker. And in Germany you have Fisaton, and they make a lot of replacement speakers, usually in higher quality. It's only $10. So I put that exactly in spot from the original one, which also helped with sound quality. This is the soundboard. And this is the board that is added. You see it is very small. You have to do like 3 wires attached to the original board. And what you do is you have the original signal coming from the tone arm. That goes into this board. There you cut the signal wire. You go to the preamp, go back and then continue. So to do this you also have to remove 2 capacitors from the board. Not that exciting to see, but this is where you remove it and where you put in the wires. And as soon as you do that, you amplify the signal and you get a much more sound from your speaker. Now, of course, how does it sound? But before I do that, here you also have the battery. This is the normal position where you put in your standard alkaline batteries. I replaced it with a lithium battery. Rechargeable, and I must say that's maybe the best modification on this unit. Now being able to just charge it up, and I use this one, lithium battery. You can buy it also on eBay. This is the 12 volt, 6800 milliamps. This thing runs forever with this. It's, I think, at least like 100, 200 records maybe you can play. It just keeps on running. The only time it runs out of juice is when I forget to switch it off overnight. And that happens, usually because I don't think anymore about switching off. Now let's put it back together and play some music. now you have the right tone arm. You have the tracking force reduced to only from 8 to only something like 2.5. You can now play your most valuable records on this table without ruining them. So let's do that. Let's put on an expensive record and let's play some music. I will take some James Last. So what in general, the first thing you will notice is that the preamp I'm using is putting too much back there, amplifying the signal, so I can really overload the signal. At least you can play it loud, but it's too loud. But if you're using it like till 10 o'clock, you still get a very good sound, because that is what you will notice firsthand. The music is much fuller, much more vibrant, much more alive. Extensions low and high are better, especially the highs. And one thing I noticed, that all my music sounded a little bit off. And then I checked the RPM of the unit with this app on my phone. And to my surprise, it was running most of the time at 35 RPM instead of 33. But with the pitch control, you can easily adjust. So now it's running, for example, 33. This was the original speed. I never noticed this. I don't know if I changed something electrically, why it increased the RPM, or if it was just, it was increased but I couldn't hear it. So, when you're planning to do this, how much will it cost totally? So you have the speaker, which was about $10. You have the cartridge, $20. You have the amplification board, $30 something. Lithium battery from China is also something like $30. So all in all, I use close to $100 to modify it. And yes, exactly. That is exactly the same price of the turntable itself. So I doubled the price. Is it worth it? Well, I think if it was a fixed turntable, just go a category higher and buy something which already is equipped with a moving magnet. For portable turntables, I don't know if that's available. So a portable turntable, on the other hand, is so much fun. When you take it with you, when it's sunny outside, you can play music outside. And when you see your record spinning and you hear the music, for some reason, it's much more enjoyable. I hope you also enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. See you next time.